don't tell me if I'm dying, 'cause I don't wanna know if I can't see the sun. So, I'm going to do a really quick, wicked, messy little clown. So, it's going to be super fast. It's going to be like two or three colors. I put a little bit of a primer on my face to start lightening. I want to try and get a very light porcelain type color. And then I'm going to use like red and maybe some black, and that's it. So, we'll see how it goes. I will probably use, let's see, some wolf white to get the white color, but I don't want it to be just like flat white, so I'm going to probably also add a little bit of this diva dust to give it a glisteny effect. And then I might use a little bit of the wolf face art and FX paints. I know they're messy. I'm a messy artist. I might use a little bit of the red just for some of the details, but I'm probably going to draw a lot of them in with blood gel, as well as some cream paints, some cheap cream paints. I might use some cheap white cream paint as well, just to give it that kind of messy smeared effect. All right, this is what I've got so far. I know it doesn't look like much right now, but I wanted the messy, smeared, almost sweated look. I see I missed a spot here. I'll go over it just a little bit. But what I did to get this effect is I used the wolf white, like I had shown you, with a big thick brush. Took a light, very watered down layer over my whole face. And then I took just a little sponge, very lightly damp, and I went over and dusted and stippled until I got a smoother look, so it didn't look like there was any brush strokes. And then I took my diva dust, which this stuff is nice because it smells really good and it's made with honey and don't read all of this stuff on the front. And it gives a very, very light shimmer effect, which I'm hoping will look almost like sweat. So yeah, that's where I'm at so far. Now I'm going to add some red and blood. All right, before I start mucking it all up, so here I just did like very, very simple, and I had to like force myself to be messy. And before I started smearing it, I wanted to show you how simple it is. Like I used cream paint because I liked the red color better. I wanted it to be red and not pink. I'm going to go back over all of this with blood gel, and maybe some zombie colored red as well to make it a bit darker. And then I'm probably going to drip or splatter a little bit of blood, smear a little bit of blood, and it's very simple. It's very fast. And I will also probably put on some messy, clumpy eyelash mascara stuff. So yes. So here is my snapped clown, 5-minute makeup, super easy, very few things that you need to use. You could probably even finger paint it. You could probably do it without any brushes. So I splattered up some paint on it, smeared. I actually did put blood gel over everywhere I had put red paint, except for my nose really. And this makeup I think would get better as the night goes on if you're working a haunt, because even though I used a touchable paint, you can totally touch it. It's not cream paint, so it's going to stay put for the most part, but a little bit of sweat and messing around will make it look even better. I like blood gel. I like blood gel. I like to work with blood gel. It's fun. So quick, fast Halloween makeup, haunt makeup, whatever makeup. Hey, wear it to the grocery store. I do sometimes. Hey guys, so I've started sketching the portrait on the piece of wood that I'm gonna do. I don't know if you can see it very well. The picture I have is kind of vague, and I didn't actually know this guy, so I'm flying blind, but I hope it turns out okay.
Alright, so here I am. I had sketched it on and I'm starting to burn it in. So far it's looking okay, but still got a ways to go. Alright guys, so I'm making myself stop shading because that is something that happens when you do this kind of work, is like you keep adding and keep adding and keep adding and then realize you should have stopped. So I think this is about as good as I'm going to get it for him. His name was Christian, by the way, in case anybody knew him. He died recently in Lake Elsinore. All right, so I finished the wood burning process. Here he is. That's one of my more challenging portraits. My picture that I had was not very high quality, so I had to kind of fill it in myself and figure out what to do with some of the parts, but I will put the picture on here as well so you can see what I was working with. I hope his family likes it. Hi, out here in the shop. So this is the last step to making my plaques that I make. This one is unfinished. This one has a finish on it. This is one that I made a while ago. But you can see when the light hits it right, there's a shine. Sometimes I do them very glossy, sometimes I don't. I use something like this. And you can get them at craft stores. There's different kinds. I usually go for something high gloss or triple coating. That way you don't have to do as many layers to get a nice shiny finish. And I will be covering this in it. I'll probably do 2-3 layers. Just depends on how the wood takes it. When there is less burned parts of the wood, it absorbs it more and it takes more to coat it, or if I don't put any paint on it or anything. So yeah, and then that will be finished.
I'm on.